So this is Mark, the tribe representative from the Winnemem Wintu tribe, and thank you for
participating with us.
My name is Mark Miyoshi. I am the Tribal Historic Preservation Officer for the Winnemem Wintu tribe. And first of all, I'd really like to thank Water for their work, their great work here in the community, and their fundraising, and their support of the tribe. You know, we have, even though we're going in on this petition and this lawsuit together as co-petitioners and co-plaintiffs, you know, we've been working on different avenues here, and the tribe is basically basing our issues on the completion of AB 52, and I'll go ahead and get into that in a little bit. And then Waters has been doing all the other work that Bruce, you know, outlined here. So, and then they graciously offered to include us in this lawsuit and petition. So we're very grateful to Waters and all that they do. Let's see. Let's start. As I said, our issues are around AB 52. AB 52 is an amendment to CEQA, and what AB 52, and this was, it's fairly new. It was passed by the legislature in, I think, 2014. And so it's pretty new. It's statewide. Basically, what AB 52 does is it establishes a new category of resources that is given the same status as, say, air and water and visual resources, that kind of thing. And it is given the same, and CEQA is then required to study the adverse effects of a project on cultural resources, just as it needs to study the adverse effects on other resources in the state. Since it is so new, there's no case law on AB 52. This could actually be one of the first cases that actually goes to trial, if that's what happens. And we would actually be establishing some case law. And our issue is that we have what we call a tribal cultural resource. That's a new term that's defined by AB 52. And that a tribal cultural resource is a resource that a tribe has a particular cultural and historic interest in. And for us, I'll just talk about it generally. I can't talk about anything specifically, but
you need to tell why.
Pardon?
You need to tell why you can't talk about it specifically.
Yeah.
In case people ask questions that you can't answer.
Because information that is particular to a tribe's culture is kept confidential, and is kept confidential by law. And you know, the reason for that is that that other people can't use that information in a negative way, whether that's going out and destroying or affecting a particular cultural resource, or you know, using it in their own kind of ceremony, or you know, some way like that. So that's why particulars about cultural resources are kept confidential. In this case, in our case, we do have cultural resources that are water and water-based, and water for our tribe is really central to our beliefs. We are the Winnemem Wintu tribe. Winnemem means middle water people. Winnemem means middle. Mem means water, and that's because our tribe basically came from the McLeod River drainage, which is, you know, McLeod River is in between Sacramento and the Pitt River, so that's why they call it the middle water. And
in the south side of the mountain.
Yeah, we're on the south side of the mountain. You know, we also, our area also traditionally included areas of the lower pit and the lower Sacramento. And now that the other other wind two have been basically exterminated from the Sacramento River, we have, our tribe has taken over kind of guardianship, taking care of the Sacramento River drainage and so on. So, and there's a lot of intermarriage between the bands. So our leadership actually is intermarried with families that come from the Sacramento River. So, and let me get back to AB 52. Oh, so what AB 52 requires is that a proponent of a project begin consultation with a tribe that has a particular interest in a project area. And the object of the consultation is to find out, number one, if there are TCRs within the project area or that would be affected by the project, and then how to avoid any adverse effect or mitigate adverse effect, or you know, somehow to try to minimize how the project affects a TCR. And we engaged in this consultation process with the county back in June, way back in 2015 is when we started. And it's been a long process, but it actually has been a good process. We were pleasantly surprised with the county that they would engage with us in a manner that we felt was they seemed to be open and to our concerns and to what we were saying. And in fact, we proposed that we had three different TCRs that would be affected by the project, and county agreed. And they said, well, yes, these are TCRs under the definition of AB 52, and they could very well be affected by the project. And that's a key statement in itself, because if an agency or a proponent of a project, you know, acknowledges that a TCR could be affected by the project, then you know, AB 52 requires them to do the consultation, to do the study, to find out how, what kind of effect the project would have, and what they can do to minimize that effect. And we, it's a long process, and we have to go back and forth. It's not just a one day kind of sit down and say, well, this is our TCR, and this is what the county's going to do, but there's quite a bit of information that went back and forth. So, and we had different, the process kind of was developing a lot, because this is kind of the first time for us, for the Winland tribe, to go through this AB 52, and it was certainly the first time for the county to go through AB 52 consultation. So we're kind of developing things as we go. And we were at one point trying to get the county to hire an ethnographer to help both the county and the tribe develop the kind of information that the county could use in their EIR. So developing information on the TCRs and the kind of effects that the project would have on the TCRs, and the significance of the TCRs to the tribe, and the significance of the impacts on the TCRs. And we had gotten to the point where the county had agreed to hire an ethnographer, and we were in that process, but the county, the county put out a call for proposals. They only got one back, and that person that she was the preferred candidate from the tribe, was, you know, she's very very well respected in demand among agencies, among private companies, you know, to do this kind of ethnographic and archaeological work. So she was tied up until, you know, into the new year. And this was back in the fall of last year that we were getting the ethnographer hired. So when the county saw that it was going to take quite a while to get this ethnographer on board, the county had their own deadline. They wanted to get the FEIR certified, you know, last fall. And the timeline for getting the ethnographic work was going to be longer than that. And so they simply made the determination that they were going to terminate the consultation. And so that's our main issue in this petition, in this lawsuit, that the county arbitrarily terminated the consultation, not according to AB 52, not according to the law. And so I think we have a good case on this. There's a lot of, you know, I'm no attorney, and, you know, there's some things that I just, sometimes I don't know what courts do, frankly. And sometimes it doesn't seem like they're doing things according to the law or even according to logic. But we know for sure that this consultation was terminated arbitrarily, and we're trying to make the best case we can. The other thing the point we made in the petition was that the FEIR did not state any upper limits for the amount of groundwater that could be extracted, and Bruce touched on that a little bit. And for us, for our issue, for the AB 52 issue, you know, we're saying that because the county and Crystal Geyser is not saying how much water is being extracted, there's no way we could really talk about the kind of effect the extraction of groundwater is going to have on a TCR. I mean, the kind of numbers that we saw in the FEIR talked about groundwater extraction of, you know, 40-60% more, you know, on a daily basis and on a yearly basis, you know, from the groundwater stream right under deck 6. And, you know, to me, and just about to anybody, I would think, you know, that is significant. That's a significant extraction. And I don't see how anybody could say that that has no effect. And since there is no cap on the amount of water to be extracted, they could be extracting more. They could take 80%, 90%, they could take 100% of that water. You know, there's no limit on that, and the county is saying that they have no way of regulating that amount of water. And of course, when you take out 100% of the water, you're taking out 100% of the water from our TCR. And that is an absolute negative effect. So, I mean, I think we have a good case, but again, you know, the way I just don't know how the attorneys and the courts are going to interpret it and what they will do. Okay, so what we're asking for in our prayer is that if we prevail, then we are asking that that consultation with the tribe be reinstated, that we get restarted, and that we talk about in our consultation, you know, the kind of significance of first the resource, what is the significance of the resource to the tribe, and then what is the significance of the adverse effect, you know, to the tribe. So we would want that consultation to begin again. And then of course we know we're totally with Waters on all of the other issues that they have brought up, and So that's kind of where we're at right now.
Yeah.